This video is a brief video of mistake by a new mother. Now, one new mother will be having 150 ideas got from internet, 250 ideas got from their relatives, and 350 ideas from their neighbors. Every idea gets into their head and the brain is extensively filled up with idea, and no way they can process and do whatever things they intend originally to do. And they have a huge expectation from the baby, and babies absolutely doesn't behave like their husband. Baby is opposite to their husband. Whatever mother intend to make the baby do, baby does the opposite of it. A really disobedient baby. So what happens is, before pregnancy itself, you need to plan your baby. If possible, if it happened to be pregnancy itself, keep on talking to the baby, follow rituals in proper taking of diet so that baby becomes a good baby. Make yourself a good person so that you don't become angry, you become calm and quiet, you take normal diet. Every variety of item should be taken up by you so that the baby will take up every item later on. You do minimal exercises. If the doctor has advised you bed rest, then it is another thing. But mostly, if it is no problem, then you keep on doing some small exercises right from the pregnancy so that the baby in future will go and hit the gym and doesn't become overweight, and baby also plays around. A resting mother fully bed rest, then the baby, there is a chance that the baby will also become a lazy baby. Think positively, don't watch nonsense serials which are displayed in the all channels recently. It all contains lot of tension and fights and everything, and it will create a bad impact in your thoughts, and thoughts are transmitted through the nervous system into the baby also. So make sure you think rightly. And another thing, after delivery what happens is, baby will have night duty for 2 months. So make sure you are prepared to sleep with the baby. Another mistake what people do is, they keep the baby away in another bed. No, never the baby should be kept away in another bed. Baby should be kept with the mother. And don't share heavy blankets, but you can share the same bed. And baby should be near the mother so that touch of the mother and touch to the baby, and baby can feel a soothing effect, and baby can feel the smell of the mother. Another mistake parents does is, they wear perfume. No perfumes or powder over the baby or mother, because this will manipulate with the smell of the baby and baby will not get that smell of or taste of the milk. Another thing mothers does is, they don't feel like breastfeeding. They may not be ready during the pregnancy for breastfeeding. Nobody would have counseled them for breastfeeding. Their nipple might be inverted, or they might have problems. Make sure these small problems before pregnancy you sort it out, and even if after pregnancy you have some nipple problem, get your gynecologist to sort this out properly. Then another mistake is, they don't put the nipple deep into the throat so that nipple becomes cut. Proper positioning and proper attachment is very important, otherwise your nipple will get cut. Next mistake is, they don't keep enough pillows below the elbow in support of the baby. Another mistake is, baby is not raised up to the level of the chest. Baby is kept in the lap. You need to raise the baby by putting the elbow and supporting the spine with your forearm. Another mistake mothers do is, they don't take spices like jeera, which is called cumin, fennel, which is soft, and fenugreek, which is called methi dana. If jeera, soap, and methi, fennel, cumin, and fenugreek is not taken at proper amounts with 3-4 liters of water, there won't be enough milk for the baby. Another mistake is, they won't take care of stitches and their posture. If there is pain around the spine, shoulder, elbow, or back, or leg areas, or stitches areas, due to the pain mechanism, the amount of milk will be reduced. So you need to make sure the milk correctly is produced by taking lot of water and lot of spices. Another mistake mothers does is, they don't take rest in the morning time. They keep on doing something, and they fail to take care of rest. You need to understand, 2 months it is night duty, so you need to take rest properly. Another mistake mothers does is, they stop taking this jeeras of methi or spices after few months or few weeks. No, you need to continue for 2-3 years. Another common mistake is they don't synchronize their milk. You have a night duty, you need to take more amount of water during the night time. That too 15 to 20 minutes before the expected time of baby might be asking for milk, which you will get to know in a few days. Another mistake mothers does is we ask parents to keep in 3-4 hours of sunlight. If it is too much hot or too much cold, then give it through a window of the car or window of the house which is facing towards the sun, and keep the baby exposed on the upper body as well as whole body with minimum clothes, front side as well as back side. If you do it properly, absolutely we can guarantee you 95% of the babies will not get into the phototherapy machine, compared to the 70% phototherapy risk in nowadays and 20% going into the phototherapy machine. Another mistakes these mothers do these days is they don't make a Indian hammock or Indian swing, which is desi jula made of sadi, hung up from the roof. That is a very important mother substitute. It acts like a uterus and it increases the brain growth of the baby and it increases the cognitive function and IQ of the baby. It's very important. Another mistake parents does is after 1 week of jaundice, by removing it through sunlight 3-4 hours, you need to reduce the sunlight to 30 minutes, at least 15 minutes. So 15 to 30 minutes of sunlight is very much important. If it is summer or winter, indirectly or directly you can keep it depending upon how the baby tolerates it. If you doesn't put that, bones become softer and weaker and there can be flattening of the head. It's a very important thing. To prevent flattening of the head, you need to give some tummy time. Keep the baby over the tummy for playing, not for sleeping. So, and use a mustard seed pillow. It acts as an acupuncture. It's useful for brain as well as for soothing effect, as well as maintaining the shape of the head. It's very much important. Okay, make sure this one side of the head, if the baby sleep on this side, you make sure the position of the mother changes. Sometimes what happens is mother sleeps on the left side and baby on the center, father on the other side. You interchange the position so that the child gets both sides and the head is remaining correct. Another thing you can do is reverse the head to leg position of the baby also. Sometimes baby might be looking into a light. So you can't change the light position. You need to change the position of the baby so that head remains normal. Another mistake my parents do is they don't use nose drops. Nose drops, regularly you can put the head 90 degrees down and put 4 drops on each side. 4 drops on each side, saline drops. All nose will get blocked. Whatever it is blocked, it will get removed. You keep that position, 90 degree position for 20 seconds and it will get removed. You can easily prevent this ear infection. Lying down and feeding doesn't cause a ear infection. It is the improper use of nose drops which is causing nose infection as well as ear infection. If you do proper nostril toileting, you can easily remove that. Some people use a mucus aspirator also, and it's also wonderful, but saline is the best and wonderful thing everyone can do. Another thing most people do is the baby cries a lot in the night. That is because of this getting blocked. Put the nose drops properly, it get improved. If you don't get properly putting it, there will be excess crying. That might be due to a ear pain. For that you can give some paracetamol drops of any company. You can give in the bottle of the paracetamol itself, there is written how much dose is to be given. That you can do. Another thing which is very common is excess use of animal milk by mother. Excess use of animal milk by mother also can cause rashes over the baby, which is might be starting of atopic dermatitis. For that mother might have to reduce the doses of milk which is taken by the mother. Another very common mistakes which almost all mothers does is they give extra formula milk. Initial few days might be required. After that, you can increase your feed by taking more of water, and you need to slowly reduce the amount of top feed formula, because formula is not a very essential thing. It's just an infant milk substitute. It's a substitute of mother. Another mistake which these mothers do is they give only feed for 6 months or so. You need to continue feed for 2.5-3 years, at least till your baby is 6 months into school, so that almost all diseases will be protected by additional protection from mother milk. This is an important thing. Don't hastily stop this mother milk. The baby should go into the school and still continue mother feed 2-3 times, and when the baby is fully immune with the almost local diseases which is happening in the school, then you can easily stop these things. Another thing what these parents big mistake they do, they cut the nails, and during the cutting of the nails they might injure the side. Make sure during the sleep only you cut the nails. And you cut it every third day, fourth day or second day. Only one time you can cut 2-3 nails. After that baby will wake up. So you have patience, you cut it. If you don't cut it properly or don't smoothen the edges, it can injure the ear. Another thing we have been seeing very common is eye discharge. For that, what you need to do is massage the corner of the eye 20 times per day. Every 6 hourly you need to wait 20 times every 6 hourly, that is 80 times per day you need to massage, and it might take around 6 months to 1 year for these things to recover. Very rarely this excess of vomiting will be there, that might be due to intestinal problems. We have seen babies, lot of babies, but these are rare. Very rarely babies can choke up on their milk. So immediately you can put it in over the left side stomach and tap the back so that it comes out. These are all rare problems. Sometimes what happens is we have seen the parents warming up the bathing water, and after that they might be going around in search of the baby's diaper and everything. By the time they come back, this water might have become cold. You put the baby immediately and baby might stop breathing or something. So make sure the temperature of the water in which you are bathing the baby is kept normal. This bathing difficulty, bathing time, you should be very careful so that it doesn't go in. Sometimes soap goes into the eyes and all, that is rarely causes any problem. So soap goes into the ear, these and all doesn't cause problem. But the lesser temperature water if you use, suddenly there can be breathing difficulty with the baby. Another thing we are seeing with the baby is the parents don't know how to calm a fussy baby, and baby over a period of 3-4 weeks becomes extremely irritable and a really fussy baby. Make sure initially for the 3-4 weeks you need to regularly visit the doctor and get the weight checkup of the baby, establish the mother bonding, establish the feeding technique and everything properly, so that you get the time of 3 weeks in which you get a good baby. If you initially don't put this effort, within 3 weeks to 1-1.5 months the baby becomes a very irritable baby who is going to press your nerves like anything. He won't irritate you like anything. These are the common mistakes, you know, gas mistakes, the feeding technique mistakes, the thinking mistakes of mother, insufficient milk production due to lack of spices, lack of water intake, desynchronization of this feeding. These everything you need to take care of so that things goes normal. Keep watching Dr. K. Babu channel. Take care. Have a good day.